Yes, good morning. So here are some MCQs from the chapter, which you are to identify from your side. The MCQ question is, choose the correct option that lists the facts about, choose the correct option that lists the facts about how the postmaster reacted on seeing the letter to God. How the postmaster reacted on seeing the letter to God. A, option A is, he ignored it. He ignored it. Second, he asked the postman not to entertain it. He asked the postman not to entertain it. Third, he sent back the letter to Lenko to write the valid address. He sent back the letter to Lenko to write the valid address. He laughed at the letter. He admired the writer's faith in God. Next option. He laughed at the letter. Next option is, he admired the writer's faith in God. So what will be correct? What is last option? He admired his faith in God. Okay, next question. Choose the incorrect set of options about what Lenko said to his son. Choose the incorrect set of options about what Lenko said to his son. Got it? Number one. A plague of locusts would have left more than the hailstorm had left. A plague of locusts, locusts, would have left more than the hailstones had left. Second is, this year they would have no corn. This year they would have no corn. This year they would have no corn. He asked his son to help him. Third option is, he asked his son to help him to put away the snow, from the field. He asked his son to help him to put away the snow from the field. Fourth option. They would write a letter to God for help. They would write a letter to God for help. One more sentence. He asked his son to take the letter to the town. He asked his son to take the letter to the town and place in the mail. He asked his son to take letter to the town and place in the mail. Let's see. Write one more. there all years hard work had gone in vain. Their all years hard work had gone in vain. Their all works or whole years hard work had gone in vain. So children, in these sentences, now write the options. Options I have to give you, then only you'll be taking the correct option, correct pair, which is incorrect. Okay, so how many sentences I've given you? Should I give me, because I've given you different ones. So first and second, your A options are, you write A, statement number 1 and 2 like this. So you have to identify whether these two statements are incorrect, right? Then option number 3 and 4. So which number is this? He asked his son to help him to put away the snow from the field. Third. And which option is it? They would write a letter to God for help. Fourth. Okay. So how many total options are there? 6. Okay. Okay. So now, what is the incorrect option? Out of these 4, there is one pair which is about incorrect statements. So which pair shows incorrect statements? First of all, you people tick the options which are correct. It means that they should not be there. And the both of the options should be correct. Then only that option will be your answer. Though the question is very simple, but what is complicated? The way the question has been asked. Okay, first of all, you tick the correct options. Your first option was, a plague of locusts would have left more than the hailstones had left. This is correct. This is what he said to his son. So this is not your answer. So put a cross on your answer now. Put a cross on this statement. Because cross would tell you that you don't have to see this answer. This is not your answer. Because you are to choose the incorrect option. Are you listening, children, here? Okay, second is, this year they would have no corn. This is also he said. So this is not your answer. Because you are to choose the incorrect option. So put a cross here also. Right? Third question is, he asked his son to help him to put away the snow from the field. Did he say this? Did he tell his son to put away the snow from the field? He did not say this. Okay, those children who write many gossips on their own in the answers, they might not be knowing it. So those who read the chapter very carefully, they know that he never said this thing to his son. So put a tick here. So this third option should come in your answers. So third option is there. Okay. But the examiner here, I have written without thinking, so the option could have been like this. So you will say, like, here also it is there. Suppose I put here also. You will say it is also here. So three options are third and fourth. Okay, let's see. Never mind, you just focus upon your right answer. So fourth statement is, they would write a letter to God for help. Did he say this to his son? He did not say this to his son. It was his own decision, which he thought later on his own. So even fourth statement is your answer, because you have to find incorrect statement. So fourth is also here. So this option is coming correct. So your answer is B, because nowhere else fourth option is given. बाकी भी देख लेते हैं शायद कोई और हो, बाई मिस्टेक मे बी गिवन. ही आस्क्ड हिज सन टू टेक द लेटर टू द टाउन एंड प्लेस इन द मेल. सो डिड ही से दिस टू हिज सन? व्हाई व्हाई इज दिस? यस, ही मेल्ड इट हिमसेल्फ. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो इनकरेक्ट. तो ये भी आना चाहिए था. सो लेट मी पुट. ओके ओके. सो देयर ऑल इयर्स हार्ड वर्क हैड गॉन इन वेन. डिड ही से दिस? यस. सो दिस इज नॉट योर आंसर. सो आर आंसर्स आर थर्ड, फोर्थ एंड फिफ्थ. सो बी ऑप्शन वॉज करेक्ट. गॉट इट? सो टैकलिंग दिस काइंड ऑफ क्वेश्चन विल बी अ लिटिल ट्रिकी. Otherwise, the question was not at all difficult. So this question will give you a clue to how to read the paper, chapter so carefully, right? Though this story is very interesting, easy, and here you are very easily able to make out like what he said and what he did not. But in the chapter like Nelson Mandela, or even in the chapter like the 100 Dresses, where there are multiple, you know, characters, there sometimes it becomes confusing later on as to who said this and whether he or she said or not. So you are reading this to be very, very strong. Anji Khushi. Okay, right, next question. So what will be your answer? Option B. B. In the end, when on the OMR sheet, you'll be encircling B point. Okay, so next question, write down. It can be in the form of blanks also. For example, write, choose the option that completes the following sentence. Choose the option that completes the following sentence. Number the question itself is the hailstones dash. The hailstones dash. Now the option number one is ripened the crop of his field. Ripened the crop. B option, blossomed the crop. Third, saved the crop from destruction. Saved the crop from destruction. Number four, destroyed the crop of Blanco's field. Destroyed. So what will you do? The hailstones destroyed the crop of Blanco's field. So this was a very simple statement, so you could very easily complete it. But you can imagine if it is from the chapters like Nelson Mandela and all, then it would be a little difficult. Okay, now write next question. So pick the option that correctly classifies. Very important question. Pick the option that correctly classifies facts and options and opinions of the students below. Pick the option that correctly classifies facts and opinions. Pick the options that correctly classifies facts and opinions of the students. Now there is a pictograph. Pictures are there. A speaker, first student, write down A. A means the first student. He's saying Blanco was surprised when he received money. Blanco was surprised when he received money. B option. Yes, he was feeling contented. Yes, he was feeling contented. Third. No, he was angry because the money was less than demanded by him. Third option is no, he was angry because the money was less than demanded by him. Fourth option is yes, he was angry on the post office people. Yes, he was angry on the post office people. Okay, so now the options are, your A option is, you've got four sentences, 1, 2, 3, 4. Now your options are, A is, F, 1, 2, 0, 3, 4. Getting? Right first, then try to understand, I won't explain. Because in exams, how many complex kinds of questions would come? I won't come to explain everything. Okay, second option is, you can put a slash over here or equals to. I think now it is clearer. One and four, okay. C option is, and D option is, O is 1 and 4. F is 1 and 4. In B option, it was a 2 and 3. It is 2, 3, 1, 4. And last option, 1, 4. And 2, 3, 2, 3, 5. Best will be 1, 2, 3, 4, right? Yes, C is correct, I guess. No, first let us discuss, because I have written, now look at these statements. First statement is, yes, read out, Vida, Imani, you read out first statement. Blanco was surprised when he received money. So what is it? When you say that, when you say like, she was very surprised to see my good marks. What is it? Is it a fact or opinion? It's an opinion. Maybe she was not at all surprised. Sometimes you say like, she was so jealous when she saw my good marks. Maybe she was not. These are opinions, and opinions make the life worse, complicated. So what is it? Like the point over here is, what's the statement again? Was he surprised or not? That's a different issue. But what he said, that is a fact. So he was surprised when he saw the money. It is an opinion. So see, if O is having one option, so here it is there. So it's not there. So it is also there. Right? O is one. Opinion, first is opinion. Okay, second statement, Imani. Yes, he was. Yes, he was feeling contented. I am telling you that yes, he was feeling contented. This is what? This is again opinion, right? Maybe he was not contented, but I am just thinking like this. I think he was contented. It is opinion. So it is also coming here. So it is also there. There one is there, it's not here. So I guess this option is coming up so far, correct? Okay, aage chalo. Third. He was angry because the money was less than demanded. So here, if you say like she was angry or he was angry because this reason. So there, with your opinion, you are giving a reason. It becomes a fact. So third option is there. Third option is here also. So these two, but here these were not correct. Okay, next. Yes, he was angry on. Yes, he was angry on the post office people. What is it? Yes, he was angry on the people, on those people. If I simply say, yeah, he was angry, he was annoyed, then it is an opinion. He was angry on, so it becomes a little bit of fact. So here, which option is coming up correctly? So C option is correct, right? So this question, these things were nowhere in the text as it is. So here, what is required? Your own, you can say, ingenuity, the way you understand life. No one teaches you how to understand life, but it comes on its own, right? So, because literature is life. Got it, children, here online? Okay, right now, next question. Okay, choose the option that gives the correct answers of the following questions. Choose the correct option that gives the correct answer of the following questions. Got it? First question is, for how long did the British rule South Africa? For how long did the British rule South Africa? Second question is, what did Nelson Mandela become on 10th May 1994? What did Nelson Mandela become on 10th May 1994? Got it? Now the options are A, for a century, comma, president of the African National Congress. For a century, comma, president of the African National Congress. B, option B, for three decades, comma, first black prime minister of the country. Third option, C, I mean, for 300 years, comma, first black president of the country. Has the answer come or not? Answer hasn't come. For how long did the British rule over South Africa? Check from your book. So sometimes you have to remember some facts also, you know? So no book. Yes, check from the book, children. Has the answer come, children? Meanwhile, write one more option. For 30 years, comma, first president of the WPO, WHO, the first president of the World Peace Organization, or WHO कर लो आप. So the first president of WHO. Okay. So what is correct out of these all? Yes. So for how long did South Africa, for how long Britishers rule over South Africa? 300 years. And what did Nelson Mandela become? First black president of the country. Black hi tha na. He was the first black president of the country. Has he been? Okay. So these are only a few clues to do the MCQs. And the best way to do the correct MCQs is that you read the chapters and the text questions very carefully. There only you'll be getting maximum of the support. Okay, then you can do some MCQs from the reference sources as well.